Family, 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 come on in, come on in. We welcome you to night two of Jesus Week. Listen, last night we were blessed by Javante Patton and Minister Diamond Gant. And tonight we have with us the one and only Miranda Curtis. We have with us the one and only Dr. John Faison, all the way from Nashville, Tennessee. God is working up in here. Send this link out, press share, do whatever you have to do. We want you to enjoy this night two of Jesus Week. We have ministers that are going to bless us. We have guest pastors who are going to stop through to lead us in communion. You never know what's going to pop off on the virtual ship. So I thank you for tuning in, and I pray that this entire worship service will be a transformative experience. Hey, how about right now? Let's just pause even at the top, and let me give you an opportunity to sow. So there are seven ways to give every night this week. I'm asking you by faith to join me and my wife in sowing a $20 seed. You don't have to fight and figure out what it is. Every night of Jesus Week, by faith, I'm charging you and I'm inviting you, I'm challenging you to sow a sacrificial seed of $20. Some of you say, Pastor, that's no sacrifice. Well, I don't want to limit your faith. You do what you can. But every night this week, we're committing ourselves to sowing a $20 seed. And so tonight, I want to pray for you really quickly as we get this party started on night two. God, would you bless us tonight? That's all. We just want to be blessed. In Jesus' name, amen. I thank you, fellowship. We're about to go higher in worship. I'll be back soon and to enjoy this night with you. Peace, peace.
Praise God, fellowship and fellowship family. Thank you, Pastor Sharp, for the awesome opportunity to be able to come before the people and speak during Jesus Week. Father, we thank you for the opportunity to come and to share your word and to help us to better understand more and more about you, Jesus. We thank you and we love you. Stand in my place and speak a word to your people. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. John 16:33 tells us that Jesus said, I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Turn to yourself and say, I'm fighting a fixed fight. I'm fighting a fixed fight, a fixed fight, a fixed fight. Webster's Dictionary defines a fixed fight as a fight in which the outcome is determined before the fight even begins. Webster's Dictionary determines that a fixed fight is one in which the fight is usually a fight that is won because someone has paid somebody off to ensure that there is one victor in the fight. And I want to suggest today that we are all in some sort of a fight. And for you, your fight may be the fight against depression, and it has got you or back against the ropes. Or for you, your fight may be a fight for your health, and it is giving you an uppercut and causing you some situations that you had not anticipated. Or for some, your fight may be a financial fight where you is delivering you a jab and you can't see your way out of this financial situation. But when you think about it, all of us are engaged in a fight. Maybe it's a fight of relationships for you. Maybe it's the fight of the loss of a loved one. Or maybe it's the fight of the pandemic that has presented us all with a 1-2 punch that we can't seem to shake. But I want to say today that we're all in a fight. And for some of us, we've been fighting so long, we've been fighting so hard that we're getting tired. For some of us, we've been fighting so long, we've been fighting so hard that we're ready to throw in the towel. But I came today with some good news. I came today to give you a strategy that will help you to win this fixed fight. Oh, in wrestling, they have a strategy that they call the tag team strategy. And what happens with the tag team strategy is there is a fighter in the ring. And when the fighter gets tired, when the fighter has their back against the rope, when the fighter has been counted out, the fighter reaches out to tag team their partner in. And immediately that partner comes in and wins the fight. I want to suggest today that you need to learn how to tag team Jesus into your fight. Why do you want to tag team Jesus into your fight? Because Jesus is the one one that climbed on the cross and uttered the words, "It is finished." Jesus, I tag you in. Jesus, I want to tag you in because you're the one that conquered death, sin, and the grave. Jesus, I want to tag you in because you were wounded for my transgressions. Jesus, I want to tag you in because you were bruised for my iniquities. Lord, I want to tag you in because I can't make it no more. And I understand that the chastisement of my peace is upon you, and that thus by your stripes we are healed. Somebody out there needs to learn how to tag the Savior in. Zechariah 4:6 remind us that it's not by power nor by might, but by the Spirit of the Lord Almighty. We need to stop trying to figure it all out. We need to stop trying to fight this fight. We need to realize that this is a fixed fight, and it's already been determined who the winner is. So we don't have to go into the fight thinking it's by our power. We don't have to go into the fight thinking it is by our intellect. We don't have to think that it is our finances or our connections that are going to win the fight. We don't even have to think that it's our experiences or our education that are going to help us to win the fight. But I want to declare today that this fight ain't yours. It's the Lord's. Exodus 14:14 reminds us that the Lord will fight for you if you just keep still. Somebody needs to learn how to tag team the Lord in and stop trying to fight this fight. You're getting tired. You're getting weary. You're getting heavy laden. You're about to be counted out. So now is the time where you need to tag team the Lord in. It was the woman with the issue of blood that suffered from this issue for 12 long years. But it wasn't until she came across Jesus and she tagged him in that it was her faith that made her whole. Or it was the man at the pool of Bethesda who was sitting there waiting for his chance at deliverance. But it was when Jesus came by and he tagged him in that he was able to rise up and walk. And so I come to you today to remind you that as you are in this fight, it is a fixed fight. All you have to do is tag Jesus in and you will win.
Good evening, fellowship. Again, I thank you for tuning in to this second night of our Jesus Week. And as a part of our worship experience, each night we are being led in Holy Communion by one of our local pastors. Well, tonight we don't just have a local pastor. We have my Chicago pastor who has graced us with his presence tonight. He is the senior pastor and the lead elder over at the Greater Harvest Baptist Church. We all know him. We all love him. He has so many deep ties right here with Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church. And I'm honored. I'm so honored that Elder Eric Thomas is with us tonight to lead us in Holy Communion. He's coming in his own way. And I want us to prepare ourselves for communion. Go grab your elements, your bread, your wine, your juice, whatever you have. Gather your family around the TV. Gather yourself around the laptop. And let's be led in Holy Communion by Elder Eric Thomas.
God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. So good to be here with you and with my friend, my brother in the Lord, Pastor Sharp and his wife and the fellowship family. And this is a great occasion that we will celebrate the life, the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ during this Jesus Week. I don't know about you, but I'm so glad that the blood of Jesus still works. It still prevails. And that means everything that could ever happen to me has already been covered by the blood of Jesus. The old folks said it like this: I know it was the blood. I know it was the blood for me. One day when I was lost, he died on the cross. And I know it was the blood. Nothing else but the blood. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? You know it. It was the blood of Jesus. Come on, let's sing in this great hymn of the church. The blood that gives me strength from day to day. Come on, saints, let's say it together. Oh, the blood. Glory to God. That Jesus shed for me. Glory to God. It was way, way back on Calvary. Hallelujah. Oh, it was the blood, not just me, but you too, that gives us strength. Hallelujah. Oh, from day
from day to day. Oh, it will never lose. Hallelujah. Its power. Come on, you know that stanza. Everybody, where does it reach, sir? It reaches, hallelujah, yes, sir, to the high, to the highest mountain. Glory to God. And no matter where you are, it'll find you where you are. Oh, and it flows, hallelujah, to the Lord, to the lowest valley. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm so glad that the blood, woo, hallelujah, that gives me strength. Come on, praise Him where you are. From day, yes, sir, from day to day, it will never, it will never lose. Hallelujah. It's, come on, let's say it again. Let's say it again. Hallelujah. No matter where you are, no matter where you've been, hey, it reaches, glory to God, to the highest mountain. Hallelujah. Even in the midst of COVID-19, glory to God, Chicago, San Francisco, it flows, no matter where you are, to the Lord. The lowest valley. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to Jesus Christ. Oh, the blood. Hallelujah. That gives me strength. Yes, it does. Oh, from day. Oh, from day to day. It will never. It's power. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. It will never. Hallelujah. You can celebrate today. You can praise Him today. That same blood that is shed on Calvary is working right now. It's working in your finances, in your health, in your body, in your family. It will never. Hallelujah. It's power. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That sounds real churchy. Glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. You have hope today. The Bible says we have hope because where there was no shedding of blood, there was no remission of sin. And today I'm so glad, I'm so glad, I'm so glad, I'm so glad that He made the choice for me. That is, He could have gotten off the cross. He could have called angels down, legions of angels, and they would have rescued Him. But He died for you and me. He died, but the good news is that He didn't stay there. And you can celebrate today. Come on, hallelujah. Glory to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The Bible says, glory to God, for I received of the Lord that which also I have delivered unto you, that the Lord Jesus, the same night in which He was betrayed, He took bread. And when He had given thanks, He broke it and said, take, eat, this is My body, which is broken for you. He says, do this in remembrance of Me. He says, for often as you do it, you show forth My death until I come again. In the name of Jesus, let us all commune together. Glory be to Jesus Christ. I don't know about you, but you need to know a little secret. You just took the antidote for every disease. Hallelujah. And you just took your antibiotics for everything that could ever get into your body. And I heard an old saint say, if you can have it, He can heal it. And so today, because of His broken body, because of His blood that was shed for you, you have healing and deliverance. The Bible also said that after the same manner, He also took the cup when He had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament in My blood. Do this
And as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Bible says you'll do this until I come. Come on, let's commune together. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Come on, give God praise. This is a privilege and an opportunity. God bless you. God bless you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Right where you are, Pastor, would you just pray for us? Pray for us.
Yes, yes. Father, in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I ask you right now, God, first of all, before I ask you anything, I want to say thank you.
Thank you.
Because you've been good. You've been wonderful to us. Oh, God, you told us to enter into your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. So, God, I stop right now to say thank you for all that you've done for me. Oh, God, it really could have been me outdoors with no food. It could have been all of us, God. We could have succumbed to COVID, succumbed to diabetes and cancer. But your hand of mercy has kept us. And we want to say thank you. Now, Father, I thank you for your blood tonight.
Yeah.
I thank you for this Jesus week that we're celebrating. I thank you, God, for every speaker that will speak, God. Every song that will be sung this week. But most of all, God, we thank you for your love for us. We thank you for your care. And we thank you for the empty cross, glory to Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Father, we thank you right now, God, that as we call your name, we know healing will go forth.
Yes.
As we call the name Jesus, the name that breaks every fetter, the name that causes fevers to leave, the name that causes broken bones to come back together, the name that is above every name. Oh, God, we call your name, God, and we ask you right now, God, that you would keep this family together, the body of Christ, God. Thank you, God, for holding us together. Thank you for being there when we didn't have anywhere else to go. Thank you for being our open door. Thank you, God, for being our healer. Thank you because you were wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon you. And by your stripes, we are already healed. We thank you for the blood because it prevails in our lives. We thank you because we have victory in your name. We thank you because everything we'll ever need has already been accomplished by the blood of Jesus. And we just want to say, Lord, thank you. We don't complain about anything. We don't even ask you for anything else. But we want you to know from the bottom of our hearts that we are grateful for all that you've done for us. Keep us. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus we pray. It is so.
It is so.
Amen.
Amen. And amen, amen. Wherever you are, put those hands together and give God praise for healing. Give God praise for victory.
Hallelujah.
Come on. I'm going to say something that doesn't sound normal. Give God praise because you're saved. Come on. Give God praise because he saved you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Elder. Thank you, Elder. We thank you. Never lose, yes, it's power. Come on, never lose,
never, never, ever lose,
yes, never gonna lose,
it's power,
yeah, never gonna lose,
never, never, never lose.
We got to leave you alone, we got more to do, but
it's power.
Come on, say it one time.
Hallelujah.
For
me. It'll never, never, never lose,
yeah,
no, it won't. No, sir, it'll never lose its power. From generation to generation, it'll always be potent.
It'll always be potent.
Hallelujah.
From generation to generation.
From generation to generation. Oh, yeah.
It will never, it will never. God bless you. God bless you.
Hey, Fellowship. This next artist has found singing to be a comfort for her. Her powerful voice has lended her opportunities to share the stage with such artists as John P. Key, Kurt Carr, Youthful Praise, and so many more. She is a true worshiper and stands on the belief of worship is not a skill set, but it is a way of life. Please put your hands together for Miranda Curtis.
Hallelujah. I just want to take this time to bless the Lord for Pastor Reginald Sharp and Lady Bree for having me for Jesus Week. It's an honor to be able to worship with you all. Somebody shout, whatever it takes. Hallelujah, I'm all in. Bless him right there.
Nobody like you. Everybody lift your voice, cry out.
all. Who wouldn't serve a God like this? You're a healer, provider, sustainer. Who wouldn't serve
a God like this?
You're faithful in all of your ways, yeah. Thank you for being our sufficiency. We thank you for being everything that we need. So with our hands lifted up, glory. Thank you, Lord. And our mouths filled with our best praise. We'll be thankful unto you and bless your holy name, your sustaining name, your healing name, your providing name, your saving name. We lift you, we lift you, we lift you. Jesus, 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 hallelujah, we're forever grateful to you. Hallelujah, we love you, Jesus. Woo! You are my strength, strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Come on. Strength like no other.
Strength like no other. hope like no other.
Thank you, Jesus. Hope like no
other. Hope like no other.
Thank you, Lord. Reaches to me.
Reaches to me.
Say you are my peace.
You are my peace.
Yeah.
Peace like
peace
no
like valley, the blood, the blood, the blood. glory, 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 glory. Woo. I feel Jesus. God, we're grateful. You're pulling on me. So glad that it reaches to me. Reaches to me. Reaches to me. That's Lord applied, singing glory to your name. Reaches to me, reaches to me. Yeah, there to my heart was the blood applied. There to my heart was the blood applied. Reaches to me.
Dr. John Faison Sr. With over 23 years of ministerial experience, as a decorated veteran having served as a U.S. Army officer for 8 years, Dr. John R. Faison Sr. is the senior pastor of Watson Grove Baptist Church with campuses in Nashville and Franklin, Tennessee. He has a passion for Christ and the community, serving as a mentor and advisor to several community organizations. Let's welcome to Jesus Week, Dr. John R. Faison Sr.
Well, this is the day the Lord has made. We ought to rejoice and be glad in it. What an amazing, precious privilege we have been given to be able to share together in worship, honoring God for this amazing opportunity, this amazing week, and thanking God for all that God has done. with our lives through the life of his son, Jesus the Christ. I certainly want to honor God as well as the pastor of this people and the angel of this assembly, my friend, my little brother, Pastor Reginald Sharp. Praise God for him and the Fellowship Church and the amazing leadership that he is carrying out. We are so proud, so proud of Pastor Sharp, and looking forward to all that God will do. We also praise God for leading Lady Sharp. We praise God for her. What a blessing. What an amazing, amazing team they are together. Well, y'all, let's go to God in prayer. God, thank you for this day. Thank you for the amazing ways in which you show yourself strong in our lives every single day. Thank you, God, for the life, the love, the legacy of Jesus Christ. Thank you that now we stand on the foundation that is sure. We know that because Christ is, we can be. Now, Lord, we pray that you'll let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart allow it to be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, my strength and my redeemer. God, preach through me, to me, and for me. Send the word so your people are edified, but in all things it's your name that receives the glory. We bless you for the treasure that you've placed in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. Punish not your people now for the frailty of your preacher. Allow me to say it the way you want it said. We ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Beloved, go with me in your Bibles to the book of Romans. Romans chapter 11. We're in verse 36. Romans chapter 11, verse 36. I am reading from the New Living Translation, but I'm also going to give you probably the one you know most best, and that is from King James Version. Romans 11, 36 from the New Living Translation says this: for everything comes from him, exists by his power, and is intended for his glory. All glory to him forever. Amen. King James Version says this: for of him and through him and to him are all things, to whom be glory forever. Amen. Amen. I want to talk tonight with the Holy Spirit's guidance with your prayers from the subject, embrace your freedom. Embrace your freedom. The more things change, the more they stay the same. For several centuries, scientists and astrologers believed in a geocentric world. They believed in a geocentric world, and that belief is that the entire universe, all the planets and the sun, revolved around the Earth. Therefore, they believed that humanity was the center of everything. It was not until the 1600s that, through the work of Nicholas Copernicus and Galileo Galilei, that the world was introduced to the concept of a heliocentric world. I told you that a geocentric world has the Earth at the center. But a heliocentric world is a belief that the center of the universe is not really the Earth, it's the sun. Thus, all the planets, including the Earth, actually revolve around it. Now, centuries of scientific discovery since that time have undisputedly proven that Copernicus and Galileo were actually correct. Earth is not the center of the universe, the sun is. And everything revolves around it and not around us. Even though this humanity-centered approach has been disproved over and over again in science, we are still taking the same humanity-centered approach to society. See, in too many ways, we are still acting as if the world is supposed to revolve around us. We believe that our preferences are more important than anyone else's. We think that the world must conform to our personal desires, and if it doesn't, then something is wrong with the world, not us. No one matters more than us. No one is smarter than us. No one is better than us. And anybody who thinks otherwise is completely out of their minds. In some self-centered way, all of this makes sense to us until we actually try to live this way. Beloved, a global pandemic and its resulting impact has once again shown us the errors of our ways. We are quickly and have quickly discovered that we are not built to be the center of our own universes. that while we might think the world revolves around our humanity, we must admit that our humanity is too weak to handle that responsibility. Let's be honest, we are too fickle, we are too flawed, we are too frail, and we make too many mistakes and too many mishaps and too many missteps. We are prone to break down, break up, and break apart. Even on our best day, we still battle with our own worries and weaknesses and woes. And as a result, we discover that what we thought we wanted, we really don't want at all. We need something greater than us to lean on. We need someone stronger than us to keep us. We need somebody bigger than us to help us when we are losing. We cannot be the center of our own universes. Instead, we need a sun to revolve around so that we don't drift away from the gravitational pull of life, its losses, its lies, and its letdowns. Beloved, thankfully, Paul speaks powerfully through our text today to inform us that we have been given a son. But it's not an S-U-N, it's an S-O-N that we have been set apart to revolve around. King James Version says, "For of him and through him and to him are all things, to whom be glory forever. Amen." New Living says it this way, "For everything comes from him, exists by his power, and is intended for his glory. All glory to him forever. Amen." Beloved, I hope you don't mind, but tonight I want to share with you that Paul is really helping us to answer the question of where is Christ in the midst of all of our circumstances? Where is Christ when life as we know it begins to break down? I know you've got residue left over from the last season, and I know you're still being triggered by traumas from your yesterday. Where is Christ when tomorrow has the potential for more darkness than it does light? Where is Christ when the future is uncertain because the present keeps changing? Where is Christ in the middle of all of this? And Paul says, when you're wondering where Christ is, all you got to do is look to where he's always been, because you will discover while the world is changing, while everything else is vacillating, while feelings are shifting, and while personalities are being moved around, Christ has not moved. He is still at the center of it all. He is still unmovable, unshakable, and immutable. God is still being who God has always been. God still knows what God has always known. God is still doing what God has always done. God has the same power God always had, the same wisdom God always had, and the same purpose God always had. So the shifts and the changes that affect you and I do not shift or change the nature of an almighty God. That same God, that same Jesus that set life in motion is the same God who is walking and talking us through life's commotion. God remains on the throne of eternity, commanding the control tower of the universe and executing his will to the glory of his own name. And it's vitally important to remember that Christ is still in control forever and always. Because if Christ is still in control, then that means I don't have to be. If Christ is still sitting on the throne, that means I can relinquish my place of trying to command everything and everyone around me. If Christ is still sovereign and superior, then everything I need can still be provided and I can rest and be free. Can I tell you there's freedom in that tonight? That I'm freed from carrying the weight of the world on my shoulders. I'm freed from putting things on my back that were out of my hands. I'm freed from the unrealistic expectations that I've got to do everything and be everything to everybody. I'm freed from having to determine every outcome of my life. With Christ still handling everything I can't handle, I'm free to handle only what I can. And when life gets beyond my power and my reach, I don't have to become nihilistic. I ain't got to become fatalistic and hopeless. Instead, I get the privilege of resting in Christ while Christ works it all out on my behalf. Beloved, you need to know that life is better when it revolves around the sun.
Life is worth the living when it revolves around the sun, because that kind of life will set you free. Beloved, if you don't mind, let me pull you to the window for a moment. Listen to Paul as he provides for us the ways in which Christ does this. Paul, in his own particular way, through use of language and rhetoric, describes for you and I some of the ways in which Christ operates in our lives. Listen to Paul. He says, number one, Christ is the creative designer of life. Christ is the creative designer of life. You got your Bible, you need it tonight. Listen, verse 36, for everything, listen, comes from him. He says Christ is the originator of life, not me. It coincides with New Testament witness in Hebrews 12 and 2. It says that he's the author and the finisher of our faith. In John 1 and 3, it says nothing was created except through him. All it's conveying is that everything that has been made is the product of his hand and his foresight. That nothing that he creates then can ever catch the creator unprepared. So if anything that Christ ever created ceases to operate as it should, it is God's responsibility to fix it. That means I do not bear the obligation and the responsibility of fixing the things that break. That truth frees me from the worry associated with having to worry about fixing everything. See, the times we worry the most and lose our joy are when we forget God is at the center and we start thinking that we are. I'm preaching better than you saying amen in the virtual sanctuary. See, recognizing that God is at the center does not mean I am inactive. It just means I ain't in charge. So all I have to do is do my part and leave the fixing to God. Because the best fixers are the ones who built what was broken. See if I can help you. You got iPhone. Many of you belong to Team iPhone, but you don't take Team iPhones to a Samsung store. You take iPhones to an Apple store because they're the ones who made it. You don't take a pair of dysfunctional and broken down Nikes to an Adidas store. Cause that ain't what they do. They do three stops, three stripes, not a swoosh. You take defective Nike materials to the one who made it. You don't take Honda engines to a Ford repairman. Doesn't make any sense, because if you really want what's broken to be fixed, you gotta take it to the manufacturer, the one who handled it. Can I tell you, you and I need to free ourselves from the need to fix everything and to give it to the God who made everything. Paul's trying to free us tonight. Paul says Christ is the creative designer of life. But then he says, number two, that Christ is the chief director of life. He's the one behind the scenes. You got your Bible. It's verse 36. He says, not only everything comes from him, he says, everything, watch it, exists by his power. That God is the driving force behind everything that exists. And if God is the driving force behind everything that exists, it means I ain't. Confirms more New Testament witness here. It's in Acts 17 and 28, where St. Paul says, in him we live. In him we move. In him we have our being. In Philippians 1 and 6, he says, he that begun a good work in you, he that started something afresh and something original shall perform it. He shall make it come to pass. That everything that functions is controlled and sustained by his power. I want to offer some further relief for you tonight, that if Christ is the sustainer, then you and I don't have to be. You and I can take a nap, since Christ is going to be up all night. You and I need to rest and relax and be rejuvenated and be renewed, instead of trying to be everything to everybody. Since Christ is keeping things going, then I can stop when I need a break.
I don't have to convince myself that life will end if I take a shift off. Can I tell you, he is God, you are not. He never sleeps, nor does he slumber. You need a good night's sleep and a nap from time to time. He is self-sufficient, but I need some help outside of myself from time to time. He is not affected by the cares of this world, but I need compassion and close friends and even some counseling and some therapy to get through this crazy labyrinth of a world called life. And since he's going to be God, I should be all right with being human. Did you hear what I just said? I think I said it too fast. I want to say it again. I said, since God is going to be God, you might as well be all right with being human. Christ is the chief director of my life. Then Christ also, it means Christ can't be surprised that there will be times in my life when the systems that were used to sustain me might fail. Now, while this may surprise me, it does not surprise the chief director. Because the chief director is so good at sustaining that which he directs that he's got another system already ready to pick up where the other deficient and dysfunctional system left off. As an actor on the stage, you may not know what another person is going to say, but the director has the script and they know how it starts, how it ends, and even how to get you back on track when you drifted off. That's not just Paul talking though. That's actually the chief director talking himself. Matter of fact, if you visit Matthew chapter 6, you'll hear the chief director talking somewhere around verse 25. He says, don't worry about what you're going to eat or drink. He says, look at the birds of the air. Look at the lilies of the field. They are adorned. They don't worry about what they're going to wear. The birds of the air are not pressed about what they're going to eat. They know that the Creator has already put it in the script for their direction and their life to be sustained. Can I tell you that your Father knows what you need? Your Father knows where you sit. Your Father knows how to handle and how to get you what you need exactly when you need it. Go ahead and chill. Embrace your freedom. Christ is directing your life. I'm almost done. Paul says Christ is the chief director of life. He's the creative designer of life. Here's the third one. The reason you can have freedom is because Christ is the concluding destination of life. Paul says everything comes from him. Everything is through him. And then in verse 36, he says, everything is intended for his glory. Christ is the purpose behind everything that happens. It is all designed to lead back to him. I need some more New Testament witness. Come here. Come here. Romans 8:28. And you know, and I know, and we know that all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. Come here, Jude 24, 25. Not now, unto him who is able to keep you from falling. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, dominion, and power now, forever, and ever. Amen. All things that Christ has made and he sustains are leading ultimately to his glory. And if everything is leading to his glory, then I should not be completely shattered when tough seasons show up in my life. God help me preach tonight. I said, if everything is leading to the glory, to the power, and to the strength, and the affirmation that Christ is who God says he is, that even when life gets tricky, even when times become unpredictable, even when economies shut down, even when bodies that used to be strong and active become frail and unreliable, even when relationships that were counted upon begin to dissipate and dwindle, when all of the tough seasons begin to show up in my life, I got a guarantee.
I got a guarantee that God is intricately involved. Ha, ha, he is completely invested in my life. And if everything is gonna bring him glory, then God can take even the ugly experiences, even the painful woundedness, even the loneliness, the despondency and the depression, even the anger and the rage. God can take it all and make something beautiful out of it. That's why your ugliest seasons have the best testimonies. That's why your deepest wounds got you the closest to God. That's why when you hurt the most, you help the most people. Because God has a way of taking everything, bringing it together, blessing you, and giving glory to his own name. I gotta go. Paul says, if you know that Christ is all of these things, then you ought to chill. You ought to relax. You ought to take some moments from time to time and enjoy life as it comes. Man, I'm so sick of these masks. But you know what? I'm glad I can put my own mask on. And it's not a nurse doing it for me. Man, I'm so tired of being socially distant. But I'm so glad that I can decide how distant I want to be. 6 feet apart instead of 6 feet under. I'm tired. I'm fatigued. I'm sick of this just like you. I came to tell you, even in this, I've learned how to rest. Learn how to lean on God. I've learned that even with the stuff, the conveniences that have been snatched out of my regular routine and rituals, I've learned that Christ is still everything I need. I've learned that maybe I didn't need all the stuff I thought I did. Maybe all the stuff I had called important and priority in my life was actually getting in the way of me seeing Christ for who Christ is. Paul reminds us tonight, everything is from him, through him, hand meant to give him glory. So Paul's appropriate response to that is, all glory belongs to him forever and amen. Paul stops the thought in Romans 11 and goes into a quick doxology. He just puts the pen down in his mind for a moment and says, God, because you got all this together, you are worthy of my praise, my allegiance, and my affection. That because of who Christ is, I am now free to be who I am. That because Christ is sustaining and holding the world together, I have the authority and the power and the prerogative to step into the purpose that God called me to walk in. I don't have to worry about fixing everything. I simply have to walk in the steps that God designed for me to walk in. I don't have to be everything to everybody, but I can, yes, stand with power. And I can be who God ordained and fashioned me to be. Since God is going to be God, I can just be John. And that means I can walk with courage and confidence. It means I can live with vibrancy and vigor. It means I can engage in life with faith and fortitude. It means I don't have to carry every unnecessary waste. It means I can step in to the purpose and the plan God designed for my life. And I don't have to worry about if the sun's going to rise. I don't have to worry about if the sun is going to set. I can sit down after I've done my part and rest in the grace and the mercy of God. I can close my eyes at night and I can get me some good sleep, knowing that all night and all day, God's got the angels watching over me. I can rest and have strong faith, knowing that it's all gonna work out for my good. I don't know how he's going to do it. I don't know when he's going to do it. I don't know who he's going to use to do it. But all I know is that he's got the whole world in his hands. I didn't learn this in theology school. I didn't learn it in seminary. It was Vacation Bible School at the Shiloh Baptist Church there in Boykins, Virginia, where my teacher taught me he's got the whole world in his hands. He said he's got the little bitty baby in his hands. He's got my brother and my sister, my mama and my daddy. He's got the whole world in his hands. And that's good news tonight, because somebody watching me is worried about how your baby's gonna make it. Somebody watching me tonight is worried about you got more month than money. Somebody watching me tonight got concerned about your relationship and your vocation. I came to tell you, embrace your freedom. When you've done all you can, God will make a way. God will open doors. God will take care of you. Come here, Pastor Sharp. Can I borrow it for a moment? Be not dismayed, whatever be time. God will, I said, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide. God will, I said, God will take care of you every day and all the way. He will take care of you. If you know he will and you know he can, do me a favor tonight. Lift your virtual hands, open up your virtual mouth, and give your God a real praise. Say yes, say yes, say yes, say yes. He's got it. Go to sleep tonight. Rest your nerves. Close your eyes. Cast your cares on him. He cares for you. He can handle what you can't handle. He can fix what you can't fix. Worry is killing us more than the pandemic. We're not struggling because of tough times. You've been kissed by the ebony sun. You know what tough times look like. We're not struggling because of tough times. We're struggling because of worry. We got stuff on our shoulders that's out of our hands. You're paying rent on a house you don't live in. You're worried about stuff that may never ever happen. So that when real life comes, you got no energy because you spent it last night. Everything is from him, through him, to him, for his glory. If you were not capable, it wouldn't be in your pathway. you could not handle it, would never have shown up on your plate. Do you know that everything that comes your way has to get signature and signatory authority from God before you ever see it? Satan had to ask for permission to mess with Job. God knows what you can handle. And he also knows that whatever you're handling, you are not handling it alone. Everything is from him, through him, to him. Let God be God. You relax. You breathe. During this Jesus week, don't just go through the week and miss the Jesus part. Jesus wants to be something, do something in your life in this moment. One of the things is my assignment tonight is to remind you who he is. Get reaffirmed. Get reminded. Get renewed. And get some rest. Can I pray for you tonight? Father, in Jesus' name, I pray. For those that are watching us tonight, I pray, God, for the person who has been carrying divine responsibility in clay hands. I pray tonight, God, they'll drop it. They'll give that responsibility back to the only hands that could ever fix or hold it. Yours. I pray tonight, Lord, that you will strengthen the hearts people who are tired. I pray tonight, God, that you will minister words of comfort to hearts that have been broken so long that they don't even think being healed is a possibility. They just want to get through tomorrow hurting less than today. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll minister to families. I pray, God, tonight you'll speak to a mama, a daddy, a grandparent, a auntie, a uncle, somebody who's been carrying weight tonight. They're standing up straight, but their spirits are hunched over because carrying burdens they weren't designed for. God, I pray in the name of Jesus, they'll be reminded tonight, you got that thing, and that they can rest in you. Teach us submissive humility tonight that says, God, we can't be at the center of our own universes. We got to keep the sun there. Then God, help us to stay in our orbits so that you can strengthen us as we need you to. Bless your people tonight, God. I pray for the Fellowship Church. I pray for Pastor Sharp. I pray for First Lady Sharp. I pray for the leaders of this house. I pray, God, for fresh oil, fresh wind, fresh power to be released in all of their lives. I pray, God, that you would arise and your enemies be scattered. And we stand in the blessed assurance that everything we give to you, you're able to handle. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless for his glory with exceeding joy, to the only wise God, that Savior, be majesty, dominion, and power both now and forever. And the people of God said, amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
adore you.
Just wanna tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love
you. Lord, I love you.
Oh,
Lord, thank you.
Come on, think about it. Think about it in connection with the sermon. Say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
I worship and
adore you. just want to tell you.
Just want to tell
you. Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Oh, He's the creative designer. He's the chief director. Come on, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Come on, sing it from your heart. I worship and
I worship and adore.
Just want to tell you.
Just
He's the concluding destination.
Lord, I love you.
Yes. I don't care where you are tonight. Lift those hands. Lift those hands and say, I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Come on, come on. Tell them, I worship and
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you. Lord, I love you more.
Oh.
Come on, one more time. Come on, come on, join me in giving him some glory tonight. I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
Anybody else love him other than me? I worship.
I worship.
I owe you glory. I owe you praise. I owe you honor. Everything was made by you. Everything comes through you. Everything goes to you. Come on, come on, come on. All over the virtuous ship tonight. One more time. I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and
I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
Just want to tell you.
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you.
Hey, fellowship, were you blessed tonight by Dr. John Faison? Wherever you are, can we thank God for this preacher tonight? Help me thank God for this man of God who's come all the way from Nashville, Tennessee, the Watson Grove Baptist Church, to bless us tonight. Thank you so much, Dr. Faison. We pray that God would pour everything back into you that you've poured into us. Don't you feel some peace tonight? I mean, we're preaching like that. We have no choice but to embrace our freedom. And our freedom comes from the fact that Christ is the creative designer. Christ is the chief director. And Christ is the concluding destination. Whatever we're going through right now, listen, there will be glory after this. I mean, if that doesn't give you peace, nothing will. Nothing will. And tonight, I want to invite you to know that Christ. For those of you who don't know that Christ, I want to invite you to this church, to join a church where Christ is preached, where the Word of God is preached. And it's not about membership. It's really about relationship. You need to be connected to this Christ that runs and rules it all. The church I grew up at, Dr. Faison, we used to sing a song like this. I put it all in his hands. I put it all in his hands. No matter how great, how small, he's the master of it all. I put it all in his hands. And then when it got real, real good down in the middle of the song, they would say something like this. I put this and that. I put this, this and that. I put this, this, this. And that, I'm trying to help somebody tonight. You better put this and that all back in his hands. And I pray that you would connect with us through that email or that number at the bottom of the screen. I pray that your life will never be the same again. Can we just praise God for 20 seconds just for being the God that has it all in control? Come on, even on the virtual ship, come on, clap your hands, oh ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Come on, let everything that has breath, let everything that has breath. I said, let everything that has breath. I said, let everything that has breath. Praise ye the Lord. Why you praising him? Because he's got it. Why you praising him? Because he can fix it. Why you praising him? Because it's already handled. He's better than Olivia Pope. Yeah, he's better than the greatest fixer. Somebody give him glory tonight. Hey, hey. Let me ask you a question. Have you ever put something in his hands and it got fixed after you let it go? Have you ever put something in his hands and it got better after you released it? Have you ever put something? Give him glory on the second night of Jesus week. I said, give him glory on the second night of Jesus week. I ain't come to play. I've been through too much not to worship him. I'm about to come get you real quick. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. If he's kept you, say so. If he's brought you out, say so. If he's made a way, say so. If he's been your creator, director, say so. If he's been the concluding destination, say so. If he's been the chief director, say so. Here it is. To God be the glory. To God be the glory.
Hey, 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 hey. We got to get off the ship.
I said, to God be the glory. I said, to God be the glory. I said, to God be the glory. I know some folk don't like when this happens. I wish y'all could stay quiet. I wish y'all could stay calm. What a problem is, it ain't biblical. Make a joyful noise. Come on, take a few minutes to give. Seven ways to give are coming up on the screen. I want you to sow $20. Every night this week, sow $20. If you're able, sow $20. If you're able, sow $20. If you're able. And while you're giving, we're going to keep on shouting. And while you're giving, we're going to keep on giving God praise. And if anybody want to know what you're shouting for on the second night of Jesus week, it's because he's got it all. He's got it all in his hand. Got to get off this ship tonight, but go ahead and take 30 seconds. He's the creative designer. He's the chief director. He's the concluding destination. Give him glory now and forever. To God be the glory. Come on, help me. Be the glory. To God. Be the glory. Hey, for all the things he's done. For all the things he's done. For all the things he's done. For all the things. All the things. Hey. About 30 more seconds. You might as well get him off that couch. You might as well get him out of that chair and just give God a he got it praise. Give God a he still got it praise. Put your hands together. One more time. To God. Made by him. Everything comes through him. Everything goes to him. He's done. Hey, hey. He's done for all the things, all the bills. He's paid for all the ways. He's made for all the stuff. He kept away for all the things. He blocked away. He blocked this. He blocked that. He blocked this. He blocked that. He blocked this. He blocked that. He'll always get the glory. He'll always get the glory. He'll always get the glory. He'll always get the glory.
glory.
Excuse me.
He'll always get the glory.
Hey,
he'll always get the glory.
He'll always get the glory.
He'll always get the glory.
You've been through hell.
He'll always get the glory.
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 He'll always get the glory. Before your story is over. 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 I want you to find somebody around you. I hope y'all 6 feet away from each other. But can you look at them for a minute? Tell them, neighbor, I know you got a lot on you. Tell them, I know it's been a lot of pressure. Tell them, I know you've had a lot of tears lately. But tell them, neighbor, if you hold on, it all makes sense after a while. 'Cause God is gonna get the glory. Thank you, Miranda. Thank you, Dr. Faison. We thank you for this second night. We gonna end just like this. Ain't nothing else to be said. So may your struggles keep you near the cross. May your troubles show that you need God. May your battles end the way they should. And may your bad days prove that God is good. I pray your whole life proves that God is good. Now take the rest of the time and give him glory. Give him glory. Great name. Precious, precious, we have.
We have.
We have. I don't care how sick your relative is right now.
We have.
It doesn't matter if you lost your job recently. You still got it.
We have.
You've been up, you've been down, you've been knocked to the ground. But
we have the,
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 Fellowship Chicago presents Jesus Week. Pastor Reginald Sharp Jr. welcomes guest speakers and artists, including Dr. Gina Stewart.
Every now and then, we have to be willing to get in God's face until the breakthrough comes.
And Dr. Jamal Bryant.
As for me and my house, we shall serve the Lord.
Hear special musical guests Jovante Patton, Miranda Curtis, Rich Tolbert Jr., and Kiara Sheard. Don't miss these events as we celebrate the Christ, the Church, and the Cross. Jesus Week. Every night, March 29th through April 1st at 7 p.m. Central on Facebook Live, YouTube Live, and FellowshipChicago.com.